Welcome back to Reading English Literature Series. Hello, my name is Shabrina Farahoirunisa. I major English Literature at Sultan Agung Islamic University. Today, I'll be reading Chapter 13 from the novel Pollyanna by Eleanor Parter, entitled In Pendleton Woods. In the last episode, we know that Pollyanna met Lady's Aid. Pollyanna went to Pendleton Hill after returning from the chapel, since there were no sewing or cooking classes at that day. All of a sudden, Pollyanna heard a dog barking, then came towards her. Pollyanna followed the dog, then saw a man lying down with a broken leg. Quickly, Pollyanna approached him. The man told Pollyanna to call Dr. Chilton and gave her the keys of his house immediately. Pollyanna went to the man's house. Arriving there, Pollyanna looked frightened and terrible, because the house seemed so big, dark, mysterious, and sheltered. She assumed that the housemaid has a skeleton in it. Since Pollyanna had the key, she could immediately open the door and enter. Pollyanna quickly grabbed the phone on the table and called Dr. Chilton. She explained how was Mr. John Pendleton's condition with a frightful face. Then, she returned to the forest and approached Mr. John Pendleton. The dust has come. The three men who were identified as doctors approached them with a stretcher and other equipments. The doctor greeted them warmly, then focused his attention to Mr. John Pendleton's injured leg. That's all for today. Thank you for listening. Have a great weekend.
Hello, my name is Muhammad Azzam. I major English Literature at Sultan Agung Islamic University. Today, I'll be sharing some thoughts in Chapter 13 from the novel Pollyanna by Eleanor Parter. In this chapter, especially in the first paragraph, I really sympathize with Pollyanna, which is that Pollyanna felt disappointed to the Lady's Elder who doesn't want to take care or adopt Jimmy Bean. Apart from this case, Pollyanna is a kind child who had been trying to find someone want to take care of Jimmy Bean. And I really do appreciate Pollyanna who had Mr. John Pendleton that was smiled in the forest. Again and again, be a great pleasure to help others. In this matter, Mr. Pendleton, Pollyanna went to Mr. Pendleton's house to calling and asking Dr. Chilton help. I think Pollyanna is also brave enough when she dared to enter Mr. Pendleton's house, which people say the house is quite mysterious, and some says he's got skeleton in his closet. That's all for today. If you have some thoughts, please let me know on the comment section. Thank you for listening. Have a great weekend.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh. Welcome back to Reading English Literature Series. Hello, my name is Muhammad Ali Hasan. I major English Literature at Sultan Agung Islamic University. Today, I'll be reading Chapter 14 from the novel Pollyanna by Eleanor Parter, entitled Just a Matter of Jelly. Previously in the last episode, we know that when Pollyanna walking towards Pendleton Hill, she found Mr. John Pendleton lying on the ground with a broken leg. In Chapter 14, after the accident that happened to Mr. Pendleton, Pollyanna was a little late for the supper. Pollyanna was afraid that Aunt Polly will get mad at her for coming home so late, but it turns out that Aunt Polly wasn't home at all. After a little bit of misunderstanding, it turns out that Aunt Polly was going to Boston for 3 days after hearing a news about her brother passed away. On the next day, at the afternoon, Pollyanna met Jimmy Bean at the appointed place to tell him the result of her request to the Lady's Aid. And sure enough, Jimmy showed a disappointment. After hearing it, wishing that somebody from India will do the same thing for him as what the ladies did to that Indian little boy. After that, Pollyanna suggests another way so that they'll take Jimmy Bean for sure this time. A week after the accident, Pollyanna said to her aunt that she wanted to take Mrs. Snow's cough's food jelly for someone else. Shocked by the explanation from Pollyanna that said the jelly was for Mr. Pendleton. After that, Aunt Polly makes an excuse that she would prefer that if Pollyanna would just bring the jelly for Mrs. Snow, like usual, instead to Mr. John Pendleton. Pollyanna then explained to her aunt why she wanted to give him the jelly. After hearing it, Aunt Polly began to ask a series of questions that related with, did Mr. John Pendleton knew anything about Pollyanna? After that, she decided to let Pollyanna give the jelly for Mr. Pendleton. That is all from me. I hope everyone have a good weekend. See you next time.
to Reading Literature Series. I'm Ida Haramala. I'm major English Literature at Sultan Agung Islamic University. Today, I'll be sharing some talk on Chapter 14, It's a Matter of Guilt, from the novel Pollyanna by Eleanor Porter. In Chapter 14, It's a Matter of Guilt, I had the most really interesting on the middle part when Pollyanna knows Mr. John Pandleton. But Aunt Polly doesn't know about it. Where Pollyanna knew and provided assistance to Mr. John, when Mr. John had an accident and even broke his leg. But Aunt Polly didn't know it was happening and was very surprised. Even Aunt Polly seems to be hiding something about Mr. John from Pollyanna. He was a little worried when Pollyanna got to know Mr. John. But Mr. John doesn't seem to know that Pollyanna lives with Polly's aunt. In the next chapter, I wish Aunt Polly tells that who really is Mr. John and what does Mr. John Pendleton have to do with Aunt Polly. That's all for today. If you have some talk, please let me know on the comment section. Thank you for listening. Have a great weekend.
Welcome back to Reading English Literature Series. Hello, my name is Muhammad Jafarudin Yusuf. I major English Literature at Sultan Agung Islamic University. Today, I'll be reading Chapter 15 from the novel Pollyanna by Eleanor Porter, entitled Dr. Chilton. In the previous chapter, Pollyanna met Jimmy Pin according to agreement and wanted to write a letter to Mrs. Jones about him. After that, Pollyanna wants to deliver calf's foot jelly for John Pendleton by not telling that Pollyanna is Miss Polly Harrington's niece. When she made her second visit to the house of Mr. John Pendleton, the house is now tidy. Actually, Mr. Pendleton didn't want to see anyone, but the doctor allowed him to take the risk. After that, Pollyanna greeted Mr. Pendleton and gave calf's foot jelly. But Pollyanna accidentally told about herself and Miss Polly to Mr. Pendleton, which made Mr. Pendleton look so pale. And Pollyanna was escorted by the doctor to go home. On the way, Pollyanna chatted about Dr. Chilton and he was touched by Pollyanna's words. And when she got home, Pollyanna was scolded by Miss Polly for accidentally telling about her. That's all for today. Thank you for listening. Have a great weekend.
Chapter 15, Dr. Chilton, I had most really interesting on the middle to the end part when Pollyanna told about Dr. Chilton, who thinks is the very gladdest because the work helps many people. Helping people is a gladding job, and by helping, other people are happy. That meant Dr. Chilton felt that he was blessed and no longer complained about his work. In the next chapter, I wish Pollyanna gave enthusiasm for other characters who need a calm spirit and mind. That's all for today. If you have some thoughts, please let me know on the comment section. Thank you for listening. Have a great weekend.